In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a Solana token. This will be the first video in a series that will guide you through the process of creating and launching your token start to finish. At the end of the series, you will have a token that can be traded on all DeFi applications and be on your way to apply for centralized exchanges like Binance and Coinbase. I will be creating a utility token, but you can create a meme token or whatever you like. The steps are, for the most part, exactly the same. Before you create your token, it is advised that you have four things first. One, a website. Two, a Telegram channel or group. Three, a Twitter account. And finally, you need at least 0.7 SOL to create the token contract. Keep in mind that the social accounts do not need to be fully built. You should just have the links ready so you can add them to the metadata of the token contract. The tool that we will be using is called CoinTool. This is not a sponsored video, and there are a lot of tools that allow you to create token contracts without having to do any complex coding. This is just one that I chose after looking around a bit at prices and seeing which tools allow you to add links in the metadata. So let's begin by opening up your browser. I am using Google Chrome. Simply go to the search bar and type in CoinTool and hit enter. Towards the top of the search results, you should see CoinTool.app. You just want to left click on that. And the link for this page will also be in the description of the video. You should have landed on the dashboard page. If you didn't, just click dashboard on the left. Once at this page, look for the box that says create token. And then you want to choose the Solana blockchain. So left click Solana. On this page, start by connecting your wallet. Up at the top right is the Connect Wallet button. Okay, and once your wallet is connected, just make sure that you're on mainnet. There's mainnet and devnet. Devnet is for testing, but that's not going to be part of this video. So this looks correct. And then there's an option to create a SPL token or tax token. Just make sure the SPL token is highlighted here. Then enter the name of your token. My token is named USA token, and then the symbol that you have decided upon, I'm going to use USAT, and then add a description. Just paste it in, and you can resize the box so that you can see your full description. Next, you need to add the logo. So you should have a logo that is at least 200 by 200 pixels. The bigger the better, and if you have uploaded that on some free image sharing website or to your website itself, then just grab the URL and you can click this button here and paste in the URL. Or if you have the logo on your computer, you can click the plus button and then navigate to that image and click open. For the decimals, you have to decide on the supply, which will determine how many decimals you will need. I will flash a quick guide on the screen that suggests how many decimals you need for the amount of tokens that will be in your total supply. For me, I have decided to go with 20 billion tokens. Okay, it's a little hard to count the zeros, but right next to it on the right, you can see that there is 20B, which stands for 20 billion. And then for decimals, that will make my decimals 8. And here's where we add the social links that we talked about earlier. You just want to flip this toggle to on and then copy in your website, Twitter, and Telegram. Once you have your social links in, you can start adding your tags. These will be tags that describe what your token is. So I am going to enter another tag. Since this will be a governance token, I'm going to add governance, and I'm going to take out meme and airdrop and add USA, and it's going to be a community token, and I'm going to put NFT because maybe in the future we'll add NFTs to the project. Scrolling down a bit to the extended settings, you're going to want to make sure that you make your token immutable, but that's only if you have added your links and don't plan to change them later. But it is recommended to make this token immutable before you go live with trading. So you can make the token immutable later, you just have to remember to do it. Otherwise, you run the risk of someone hacking the links to your token and performing their own scam pretending to be your token. Revoke freeze is something that you also need to do. This is to ensure that no one can freeze trading of your token. And revoke mint is quite important because without it, you could just keep minting more tokens or printing money, which is something investors and traders do not like seeing. Okay, so just make sure to toggle on the extended settings. Each one is going to add an extra fee of 0.1 sol. And then you can see all of the fees, including the contract creation, is going to cost 0.7 sol. So go ahead and click create token now. All right, and log into your wallet if you need to. And you will be prompted with a confirm transaction from the cointool.app. The amount of Solana is 0.72116, and then you will receive back 20 billion of unknown token. The important thing here is to make sure that the unknown token amount, which is 20 billion, is indeed the amount that you put in the contract information. And if all this looks good, just click confirm. I'm not going to do that because I already created this token. But once you click confirm, the transaction will process and the tokens will be delivered straight to your wallet. After the transaction finishes processing, just go to your wallet and then check to make sure that your tokens are there. So I have my tokens, USA token. This would say 20 billion, except I have already moved some of the tokens. Depending on your project and your tokenomics, you might decide that you need to hold some tokens aside for things like marketing, development, or future exchanges. Okay, now that you have your token, you are ready to move on to the next video that I have linked in the description. This is where we will create the market ID and launch the token for live trading. If this video helped in any way, please consider giving this video a like and a subscribe so that more people can find this answer.